What's up, guys? Let's begin today with a bit of geography trivia. In Washington State, just southeast of Seattle, exists a hiking trail in the Tiger Mountain State Forest known as Poo Poo Point. It's a rather beautiful and picturesque area with breathtaking vistas, and it was given this name thanks to the sounds made by smokestacks of locomotive engines that hauled off timber back in the 19th century. Now, let's go about 2,500 miles to the east, in southern Ohio. There exists a small stream here known as PP Creek. It's a rather unassuming waterway, named after Major Paul Payne, an 18th century settler who carved his initials into the bark of a tree growing along its banks. Poo Poo Point and PP Creek, geographically speaking, are nothing alike, but they share a bond in namesake. Both sound like they were named by a third grader on a school field trip. They almost seem destined for each other, two iconic landmarks representing juvenile toilet humor tragically separated by thousands of miles. Or, at least they were separated. As in 2020, one Twitter user would go on a 36-day cycling journey to inextricably link these two locations together in spirit. It was a quest that began as one man's meme-inspired exodus from Poo Poo Point to PP Creek and ended up inspiring hundreds of thousands online with people rallying behind this man's journey. You're in for a good one today. This is the story of Ruben, the man that rode nearly 2,500 miles from Poo Poo Point to PP Creek. Before we get into Ruben's epic journey, I want to thank Ekster Wallets for sponsoring today's video. Ekster has been my preferred wallet for over a year now. I'm a big fan of their leather Parliament edition. It's slim, stylish, and super functional. Check it out. The switch on the side here pops your cards out so you don't have to go digging for plastic. Genius, right? Ekster wallets are RFID protected and they can be tracked thanks to a tracking card sold by Ekster. This solar-powered card syncs to your phone with Bluetooth, and if you ever lose or misplace your wallet, you can track its location via an app, and you can do stuff like this to find it as well.
Hey Siri, where's my wallet?
Okay, done.
You hear that, guys? Well, would you look at that?
So what are you waiting for? Check out Ekster now. Click the link below. shop.ekster.com/wavywebsurf gets you up to 35% off site-wide. It's a perfect gift for the holidays. Big shout out to Ekster for sponsoring. Now let's get on to Ruben's journey. This story begins with our protagonist, 24-year-old musician, Twitter memester, and cycling enthusiast, Ruben Lopez.
So my name's Ruben. I'm primarily a musician, but I also love biking cross country. I love everything about it.
Ruben by trade is a session drummer, and when not drumming, he's making shit posts on Twitter and crushing pumpkins between his thighs.
All right. Oh my God!
Now that's impressive. Ruben is also an avid cyclist, having completed several cross country trips in his time.
So like I've been from like Chicago to Orlando. I did Chicago to California.
In the summer of 2020, Ruben was in the middle of planning for his next cycling trip, which was to be from Seattle to Chicago, but a Twitter meme post that he stumbled upon around this time inspired him to make some changes to his course. On June 20th of 2020, a Twitter user shared a post claiming that their stepdad had sent him a text message proposing that the next family road trip would be a drive from Poo Poo Point in Washington to PP Creek in Ohio. An obvious joke, right? Well, this tweet ended up going viral, amassing close to 300,000 likes, and a spark of intrigue grew amongst those in the tweet's replies. People were asking themselves, hey, what if someone actually did this poo-poo to PP Creek route? That would be pretty epic, wouldn't it? Well, Ruben, who was previously unaware of these two laughably named locations, he became inspired by this tweet and decided that he would be the one to step up to the challenge and actually make the journey from poo-poo to PP Creek on a bicycle.
And then I saw the Poo Poo Pee Pee trip online, and I was like, oh, I gotta do that one. It just so happened that that is exactly where I wanted to go.
Before beginning his adventure, Ruben shares his intent to make this trip on social media and links to a GoFundMe with a $5,000 goal intended to help raise money for Yemen's ongoing humanitarian crisis. Then, of course, he gets prepared for this 2,500-mile meme quest that he's about to embark on. How are you preparing for this mentally, and what kind of gear are you bringing with you?
Since I've done trips like this before, I kind of know what to expect, and I'm really in touch with just like myself as a whole to be able to do something like this, because you spend hours and days by yourself. However much you decide to spend on the gear that you tried to bring, like, of course there's like essentials and stuff, but depending on how much you put into it is gonna determine how comfortable you are. What I brought was a tent, a bag of clothes. You know, I have like little things like, you know, like flashlight, hygiene stuff. And I had a sleeping bag also toward the end because it was getting cold.
On August 19th, Ruben makes his way from Seattle, Washington and travels about 20 minutes southeast to the most hallowed of excrement-themed trailheads, Poo Poo Point. He takes a photo to show Twitter that he means business, and shortly after, he begins his route to Pee Pee Creek, Ohio. He had a long road ahead of him, weeks of cycling and 10 states to traverse, but Ruben was determined to make meme history here, and he had a small group of supporters cheering him on that would only grow in time. Ruben's first obstacle on this trip would be an uphill battle through the Rocky Mountains.
So in the beginning, it starts really slow. It's probably like 60 to 70 miles a day, which it sounds like a lot, but you have, you know, from when you wake up to when you go to bed to do it. So
you just got to keep moving. You just keep moving, man. Just got to keep, you'll get somewhere if you keep moving. Feel me? So.
But like at some point, My Achilles tendons were, both of them at the same time, were just completely shot, and I was limping on both legs until I had to stop to get like, I got like some painkillers and stuff like that.
This view, all this, I love it. Don't get me wrong, but climbing mountains on a bicycle might be the dumbest shit I've ever heard of in my life. I've been doing that for like 9 days now. I'm currently at like above 6,000 feet in elevation, and quite frankly, I'm sick of it. But it's all downhill from here, in a good way.
At this point in time, he's spending at least 12 hours a day out on the road, and he needs a lot of food to keep himself going. Fortunately, according to Ruben, there's always a rotisserie chicken nearby.
So as far as for food, I mean, what kind of stuff are you eating and how are you getting it?
When it comes to food, I pretty much eat whatever I want. All the time, because I burn more calories than I could ever
consume.
Yeah.
See this right here? This is every day. Every day I have at least two or three peanut butter sandwiches. I put my loaf, I make it as small as I can so I can fit it in my shit. And then, you know, because it's all going down the same place. You don't need no fancy ass looking sandwich.
There are days where like I just have like a whole chicken for lunch and like a whole bread. And then for dinner that night is like a whole Little Caesar's pizza.
After a week or so of cycling of what Ruben says was approximately 69 miles per day, he finally clears the mountains and reaches the Midwest. His cycling speed at this point improves because the terrain is flatter. And now, I'm sure many of you at this point are wondering, where the hell is this guy sleeping?
What kind of places are you sleeping for the night when you do these trips?
I'm pretty much like throwing my tent on the side of the road. Pretty much like it's I find like a good bush or like somewhere that I just can't be like bothered or anything, or like no one knows that I'm bothering them.
Sleeping alone in the wild presents a number of dangers, and Ruben encountered his fair share during this trip. In this case, animals were a threat. Ruben had a close call with a creature of the night, nearly injuring him in the process.
So I set my stuff up, and I'm pretty comfortable with the area. So I fall asleep for like an hour. I'm like, I wake up for a second and I hear this huge animal tumbling down this hill.
Oh, shit.
And it lands right next to my tent. Like if it was like a couple feet, you know, to the right, like it could have fallen right on top of me. And I didn't know what it was at the time. And I was just laying there, you know, I was super, super vulnerable position. Yeah, I was just like eyes open, you know, like pounding out of my chest. Cause then it starts to do like this breathing thing where it's trying to like, you know, see what's around it and stuff like that. And
oh,
all I hear is like, like right, like if I stuck my hand out of the tent, I could have touched it basically. And I had no idea what it was. But you can just hear like the size when it fell and like when it's breathing.
What the fuck was it?
And so like I waited, eventually it like trotted away, but I ended up looking up like what makes those sounds and stuff like that. And so I guess it was just a really big deer, luckily, because it has that thing where it smells its surroundings to get familiar with it.
About 3 weeks into this trip, Ruben finds himself in the middle of South Dakota. At this point, his pace had increased dramatically thanks to the flatter terrain, and his body was slowly becoming more conditioned to the journey after struggling beforehand in the Rockies. Determined to push forward, he was averaging close to 100 miles a day and was making good time to PP Creek. But just as he was hitting his stride, tragedy struck. In early September, a dip in Canada's polar vortex brought uncharacteristically low temperatures to the region for that time of year and persistent rain showers. One day, this rain forced Ruben to end his cycling day early, forcing him to camp out on the side of the highway without any water, and he was running low on food. The rain kept him from resupplying. To make matters worse, a venomous caterpillar had found its way into his glove, causing a painful rash to spread around his hand. At this point, cold, wet, and in pain, he decides to hold up for the night and hope for better weather in the morning so he can go resupply at the nearby town of Murdo.
I may not show it, but we kind of struggling out here today. All right, I draw my peanut butter. I only have bread to eat. I have half a bottle of water left. The next town is 50 miles away. Tomorrow's gonna be colder than it is today.
In the morning, the rain stops and Ruben sees his chance, so he beelines it for this nearby town. Unfortunately though, this resupply run would lead to his rock bottom moment of this entire trip. Stranded in the middle of nowhere.
I get up, I pack my stuff, and I start biking it's probably like 15 miles away. Still really cold, still just nasty wind. Probably like a block before I get to the hotel, my tire pops, my inner tube. I only had one left. And, I pick up some food from the small stores they got in those towns. And so that following day I check out, I set my bike up with the inner tube, with my last inner tube. For some reason, I don't even know what I hit. I don't know if there was like something stuck in the tire itself, but another block in, leaving the motel, my last inner tube just pops. I didn't know what to do. I don't know who to ask, or I'm just a stranger, just the way that they're a stranger to me. And then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, this guy, he has a bike on the back of his truck. He asks me what's wrong with my bike, because he sees that it's in pieces. I took it apart so I can try to think of something and whatever, rig it up. I told him, dude, I'm fresh out of inner tubes, and I don't know where to go. Like, the next town is however far away. He's like, I have inner tubes, I'll give them to you. I can't even look at him because I'm I'm kind of embarrassed. I'm about to start crying because he's giving me inner tubes. And I just say thank you, and I try to get it out without my voice cracking. And as soon as he walks away, I'm just crying my ass off, dude. But that particular encounter was something that I felt was bigger than chance itself, and sometimes it just kind of plays out like that. So
in what had to be a case of divine intervention from the meme gods, thanks to this anonymous do-gooder, the poo-poo to Pee-Pee Creek dream was still alive. Ruben's quest would continue. So Ruben hightails it out of South Dakota and is blazing a trail eastwards through the Midwest, taking plenty of photos and videos along the way. While he didn't have any more tragic inner tube incidents, there were still the struggles pertaining to a cross-country bike trip. Every day presented a new challenge.
Dude, I just had to look for my phone for 20 minutes through a few spiders. Look at that thing. They're all over the place too. You gotta stay strapped.
After a couple more weeks of chilly traveling through Minnesota and Wisconsin, Ruben makes it to Chicago, Illinois, where he makes a pit stop to visit some friends and family.
Good morning. It's day 29. I've been out for so long. I love what I'm doing. Raising money, bringing awareness. That's the shit. So
and from here he's on the home stretch. Only 400 miles separate him and PP Creek. He could see the light at the end of the tunnel. He pushes through Illinois and Indiana in a matter of days and finally reaches the promised land of Ohio. He's welcomed by the rather humorously named Chartres Road. Its presence, a symbolic mimetic North Star, if you will, affirming Ruben that PP Creek is but a stone's throw away. By this point, Ruben had been cycling and braving the outdoors for 36 days. He had been virtually isolated from society the majority of this time, participating in what was likely the most mentally and physically demanding endeavor of his entire life. One can only imagine at this point in his journey the sense of blissful joy he was feeling as he pedaled along the highway knowing PP Creek was only a matter of miles away.
But I just saw what the bridge looked like and I was like, oh, I know what that sign says. You know what I mean? So I was like pulling up and I was like shaking. Oh man, it felt so good. It was really exciting.
At approximately 4:20 p.m., Ruben rolls his battered body and bicycle up to PP Creek. He finally had made it, and emotions took over.
Let's go! Holy shit, oh man. Oh my god. Oof. Oh my god. Let's go. Oh,
dude, I'm really crying right now.
It's so stupid. It's fucking PP Creek. Oh my god. Right now. It's so stupid. It's fucking PP Creek. Oh my god.
Oh, it's so wholesome. The madman did it! Poggers! Feeling exhilarated about what he had just accomplished, Ruben would then share what he did to his Twitter page. And to say that people were happy for him would be an understatement. Thousands would show up in the replies of this poo-poo to PP accomplishment. And in a short time, Ruben's tweet would receive just under 700,000 likes. Folks inspired by Ruben's poo-poo to PP quest lined up to donate to the Yemen GoFundMe, resulting in an impressive sum of $11,466 being raised. It was a beautiful celebration for one man's dedication to a meme, and Ruben wasn't even done yet. After PP Creek, Ruben decided that he would continue his trek all the way to Maine so that he could make the trip a full cross-country outing. And if possible, he wanted to visit PP Island, which was nearby and possible to ferry to. After braving some chilly conditions in the northeast part of the states, Ruben would finally reach Maine in October. Unfortunately though, he was unable to get into Canada for PP Island because of COVID restrictions. Bruh.
I actually wanted to go further than Maine. But at the time, they weren't letting anyone into Canada.
For COVID.
Yeah. So, but up there was PP Island. And honestly, I wanted to, I was ready, but they wouldn't let me.
In total, Ruben had traveled just under 3,600 miles from Washington State to Maine. And he did this in 50 days. All while becoming an internet legend in the process. This man truly put himself through hell, not just for the meme, but to raise a little bit of money for Yemen, to learn a bit about himself, and to push his cycling abilities to the next level. So what's in store for Ruben next? I'll let him take it from here.
What's the next trip? You told me earlier you had another trip, like, to top this off. Like, is this next trip gonna be your Mount Everest of toilet humor trips, or what you got planned?
Well, I'm gonna hold the toilet trips off for a second, but the next one is gonna be it's gonna be starting in San Diego, goes to Miami, up to Boston, down to Las Vegas, and then to Washington. At most 13,000 miles.
Holy shit, dude.
Yeah, I'm probably going to be gone for like 7 months.
Anything you want to say to the people watching this video? Anything you want to promote going forward?
Yeah, I have this trip coming up, which I'll be posting about every single day for the next 7 months. What's today? November? Next?
Yeah, November the 20th.
Okay, yeah, so in about a month's time, I'll be heading on the road full time and just kind of living it up. So
yeah, man, Ruben, I won't keep you any longer, dude. I really appreciate your time and coming on and allowing me to tell your story on my channel.
Absolutely, dude. Thank you so much for having me. This is really fun.
And that, my friends, was the story of Ruben's journey from Poo Poo Point to Pee Pee Creek. You gotta love it, man. Make sure you guys check out Ruben at his social media that I've got linked in the description box. He's got some stuff coming up in the future that you need to check out. So do him a big favor. Do me a big favor and follow him. I appreciate you, Ruben, so much for coming on to the show. Anyways, guys, make sure you let me know who or what you want me to talk about next, and I'll see you guys in the next one. I want to give a major shout out to my patrons. I appreciate you guys. Wavy Web Surf out. Peace.